Hey everybody, welcome back. I wanted to take a little time to go over the critical care first in bag, or the black bag. Now, if you've been in critical care for a little while, you obviously know that this went through quite a few changes. Initially, the point was to accommodate the new pumps, but really the impetus for changing it was to prevent some of the problems that we were running into at the hospitals, like if dispatch doesn't give you all the information, you could be ready with pumps, you could be ready with the ART lines, you could be ready with meds, vent supplies, that kind of thing. Whereas beforehand, you were running all the way back down, you weren't really prepared for anything. So I'm going to run through some of this stuff so you can kind of get your eye on some of the changes if you haven't gone through the bag since then. And if there's still questions after that, you can certainly come to me and I can make another one of these videos. Let's start at the front here. So if you've never seen this, this is the medication box. So there's pretty much all of the critical care medications in here. Some of them are from days gone by, like the Rock. If you want to do an intubation, you're probably going to bring all your stuff in anyway, and the Rockaronium is in the airway bag. So, you know, some of this might be redundant and some of it might not be necessary anymore, but it's there if you want it. The other thing to point out, there's sterile water here. I know that for some of our tracheostomy patients or intubated patients, we like spraying some sterile water and then some suction. If you need it, there's that. I've been working on trying to get the little pink squirt vials, in which case these would be replaced. Otherwise, tons of mag right here if you need to make up a mag drip. We don't run into that much. And then there's some syringes and vial access here in case you want that. However, this ended up being redundant because in another part of the bag, which we'll talk about, there's this stuff as well. In the side here, there are the ART line cables. So there were a couple instances where we ran into issues where it was two of the same kind. So it should be one of these Ethernet type cables and one of these half moon type cables. I've put red tape on both ends of the half moon and blue tape on both ends of the Ethernet cable, so the VITs know what's what, because they're not always going to look and see and recognize the difference. So on their stocking guides, it just says one with red tape, one with blue tape, but if you guys want to check too, that's all you need. We'll go to the other side. So this one, I hope it's coming handy for you, but it's definitely coming handy for me, is these vent supply bags here. So we put a Venturi mask or Venturi device in here just in case, as happens, we end up on a call where it's not really a vent, it's a Venturi device patient, and we can't really take theirs for some reason, so it's there if you need it. There's also, in a lot of the cases, there's those on the back of the stretcher. At the bottom of this pocket is two wrenches. This one's a little small for our purposes, so I'll replace this one. But if you have a loose connection on the vent, especially on the LTV or on the Hamilton, you can wrench it down. Sometimes the pieces come off of the hose and you need actually two wrenches. That's why there are two in here. So you turn it like that to tighten it down or loosen it up, whatever you might need. But these are always here. It's a nice reason to bring that black bag in, just in case. So we'll go through this bag here. It pretty much has everything that was in the blue case that we used to use, with a couple extras that some of you actually recommended. There's the test lung, especially in case you have the LTV and you want to just set it up, leave it on without it alarming all the time. You can hook that up and then it just leave it for a while. There's a couple of these humid vents. We don't need four of them. These are in here to help like separate different tubings. Probably just one or two is fine. Normally they don't get that tight, but it's nice to have some just in case. Two of these silicone adapters. Many of you have run into a problem before where you have to kind of make something up. I'll have another video where we talk about some ventilator or respiratory therapy tricks where you can come up with some alternatives to that. We've got several of these invasive end-tidal monitoring tubes, because if you have a busy day in critical care, you're going to end up needing some additional ones, especially if you use them all out of the monitor, forget to replace those. You end up in the ICU and you don't have them in your monitor, you got some right there. You're good to go. And then we have a lot of these swivel heads as well. We probably don't need four. I think that probably was a habit of the VITs, putting more of those in there. Most of the time we encounter somebody who's already on a swivel head or they're on one of those inline suctions, which actually does do the same thing as this. It kind of moves around so the tube doesn't have to come directly straight out of the person's endotracheal tube or their tracheostomy. But these are in here if you need them. So let's put this aside for a sec. I'll do that later so you don't have to watch me doing that. In this back pocket, very important. So here is a Hamilton circuit. It's an extra one. I would always recommend bringing up another one just in case. There have been a few instances where we needed to use a second one. Either the exhalation valve wasn't working quite right, or we weren't able to figure it out. Sometimes there are some issues with the flow sensor, and we've had to use just simply put on another vent tubing, and it works just fine. So it's nice to have that in there. The VAT is in their stocking guide. It does show it in there, and I think they've been doing a pretty good job of that. Those of you that have encountered a bag without this in it, that's usually my fault because I use the bag and I don't change it, and then I don't put it on the unsealed cart, and I just put it back in there, and then you encounter it the next time. So apologies for that. This is, I think, one of the most important pieces in here. If we want to put you guys with a bag and a vent and send you out the door real quick, some of the ALS ambulances don't have a pigtail on the tank that's on the foot of the stretcher. Most of the ambulances in the spare O2 bag have a tank with a pigtail on it. So if you're missing one off the tank at your stretcher, look in the spare tank bag and you might find one in there. Otherwise, in all of these black bags, there should be one in here. And if you get one without this simple turning thing, if it's like a hexagonal piece that you have to tighten down, you just grab your wrench, or sorry, a wrench over here, and then you can tighten it down onto the regulator on the O2 tank. All right, main pocket. So, oh, yep, that's right. So the idea with this is to make it completely ready all the time to just grab it and go. If it's sealed, then we know that it's been looked over, it has everything you need. If you're in a hurry, you don't have to worry about anything missing from it. So what I would like from you guys is that if you restock it after your shift and you don't leave it to the VITs, if you could please put a tag on it and then leave the cords coming out and make sure they're plugged into the pumps inside. Just so we know that when you plug it in, the pumps are getting charged, everything's inside is ready to go, and the person that's coming in next doesn't have to worry about it. When you do take these, make sure you take the charge cords with. Most of these IVAC pumps, the batteries have been changed out by Biomed. However, it's nice to know that you've got some backups if you end up on a long transfer. So there are four of the full set IVAC pump tubings and four of the half sets in here. And what I found is that the best way to orient this is pumps like this, the charge cords out like this on one side, you put this in like this, try to leave it in the Ziploc bag, it's just a little neater if you can, and then these come out this side, the IV supply box comes over here, and then this way we prevent these cords from getting bent too much like this. These are getting a little rarer just because they don't make them all the time and we have to order a few more. Plus, when we got rid of the IVACs, we got rid of a lot of the charging cords too. So we don't necessarily have charging cords for every IVAC just yet, although there are some on the way. In the meantime, let's just try and take as good a care as possible as of these cords. So four of the full set, four of the half set, and then we have here, if you like these Baxter tubings, I can leave them. I was sort of in there from bygone days. We certainly don't need three. I've been taking them out of some of them. It's still on the stocking guide. I can change that. But really what you need is these 200 mil bags and a 500 mil bag. So these are for your ketamine, fentanyl, or something else if you want to make that up. And here's for your norepinephrine or epinephrine if you need to make one of those up. Up here, so I put this in a box because the VAT has had some complaints about every time the bag got put up on the unsealed shelf, they had to go through the Ziploc and make sure that every one of these items was in here. So this way, if this is still sealed, then they know they don't have to go through all this. Everything should be ready. We'll go through it right now. What I like about this is that there are some of those occasions where you end up at the bedside and you don't want to ask for a bunch of syringes and IV start stuff from the nurses. You can just do it, and you can just make up one of your infusions like ketamine, fentanyl, a vasopressor that you have if you want, without bothering anybody, or even if nobody's present, you can just get it done. So we can, if you have any suggestions for this, please let me know. This is kind of what I thought might cover most of the issues that we encounter. There's one IV start kit in here, a couple of saline locks, just in case you make a mistake or if you need to start two flushes. And if you need more than that, then there's nobody around, you can always spike a saline bag and pull some out of there. There is a 22 gauge, a 20 gauge, and an 18 gauge IV needle. 10 mil syringe, which is actually more like 12 mil. There is a 3 mil syringe, 21 gauge hypodermic needle, which I like using to start most of my stuff in access vials. So I put those in there for you. Or if you need to give ketamine IM, every once in a while we encounter some issue where maybe the line doesn't work and you can't start another one and the person's coming out of sedation. Pull up a bunch of ketamine, you got it ready to go, give them IM, and then you buy yourself a little time until you can get an IV. There is a 6 mil syringe and a 1 mil syringe and another 3 mil syringe. So that should cover most of your bases, along with some just regular vial access. And then the all-important alcohol prep pads. So in another video I talked about fixing the check air sensor issue. If you don't keep these in your pocket already and you want to just wipe down the air sensor part of the IVAC pump, you can always grab them out of here. So that's pretty much it. I can't think of anything. There's the hand tevi in there. That's kind of from the old days when the idea was that we'd go to some of the outstate hospitals, we'd be ready to go. We could, if we got a kid, you can just measure them like that and then you can pull it up on your computer or on your phone, whatever. But the general idea is that it contains everything that you might need to handle those big problems as you encounter them in the ED or the ICU or wherever you might pick up a patient. It gives you everything to handle those first problems. And then if there's something extra, you can always go into the secondary bag, the blue bag, or the orange bag, and I'll cover that in another video. Okay. Thanks very much.